And today we also celebrate the feast of St. Charles Lwanga and his 21 companions. Because of their love of Jesus, they were put to death. They lived in Africa in the 1800s. But let us call to mind our sins and God's forgiveness and mercy. Jesus, you call us to love you above all things. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus, you call us to love one another. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Jesus, you call us to take care of each other. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. And let us pray. O God, who have made the blood of martyrs the seed of Christians, mercifully grant that the field which is your church, watered by the blood shed by Saints Charles Lwanga and his companions, may be fertile and always yield you an abundant harvest. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Reading from the second letter of Paul to Timothy. Remember Jesus Christ from the family of David. He died and was raised from death. That is what I teach, and that is why I suffer hardship, even to the point of being chained like a criminal. But the teaching of God is not chained, so I am willing to suffer anything. I suffer so that the chosen ones may have salvation with Jesus and live forever in glory. The same is true. If we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we stand by him, we will also share in his glory. If we do not accept him, he will not accept us. If we are faithless, he will still be faithful, for he cannot be false to himself. Remind people of this. Warn them to stop fighting over words. That does no good. It only ruins those who are listening. Do your best to be the kind of person God would accept. Be a worker who is not ashamed. Be a worker who speaks and follows the truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
law came to Jesus and asked him, "Which commandment is the most important?" Jesus answered, "The first is this: You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." The man who asked Jesus the question said, "You are right, teacher. You have only one God, and we must love God with all our heart, with all our mind, and all our strength. And we must love our neighbor as we love ourselves. This is much more important than all our burnt offerings and sacrifices." Pleased with what the man said, and so he told him, "You are very close to the kingdom of God." After that, no one dared to ask Jesus any question. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
While at St. Bernard's, we've learned the Ten Commandments and talk about them all the time. And in the Gospel this afternoon, a person comes up to Jesus and asks him, "What's the greatest commandment?" And Jesus sums it up, the Ten Commandments, by reminding us of two commandments. The first one is to put God first in everything, to love God above all things. And then Jesus says, the second is much like the first. We should love one another as we love ourselves. So if you look at the Ten Commandments, the first three commandments are how we are to address God or treat God. And the other seven commandments are how we are to treat one another. I have a story that I'd like to share with you this afternoon. And it's called the Show-Off Fan Club. Of all the birds, this one probably has the most beautiful feathers. And it is the only one who can do an amazing fan dance. You could also say that this bird belongs to a men-only fan club. That's because only the daddy peacock owns a fascinating, fabulous, multicolored fan. The peacock usually walks along quietly, dragging his tail behind him, and his tail is very long. It looks a bit like the long, beautiful train of the material that is attached to the back of a lady's fancy wedding dress. But then, the peacock suddenly does something surprising and stupendous. He lifts that long tail and spreads out the feathers until he looks like he's standing in front of a huge, fancy fan. The fan shimmers in the light with lots of colors, and it has a dazzling design that might make you think lots of beautiful eyes are looking at you. The peacock also shakes his fan, and the feathers make a loud, rustling sound. Then he prances above, walks like a soldier on parade, and sometimes does a little dance. He wants to get your attention. He wants you to notice how handsome he is. Because the peacock is so proud of his feathers, we sometimes say a person who is bragging or excited or pleased about something is proud as a peacock. Now, why do you think God made a bird with a fan for a tail? Maybe God wanted to get your attention. You might not notice a quiet little bird in your backyard tree, but you couldn't help but notice a peacock if you saw one at the zoo. Maybe God wants you to notice both. God made some birds beautiful and some plain, some noisy and some quiet, just like he made different people. But God made each bird and each person in a special way. And he wants you to notice each one and love each one just like he does. It seems to me, here at St. Bernard's, we try to remind each of us that we're all special, that we're all unique in God's created plan. And God has a plan for each and every one of us. And that's what we must come to understand. And so here at St. Bernard's School, we can address the total person, and we can talk about God and the values that God has given to us. And to respect one another as Jesus calls us to. And as we look around our world today and what is happening with so much disrespect for human life and one another, the gospel speaks very profoundly to us this afternoon. And so as you, our fifth graders, are leaving us, which we're sad, but we're also happy for you because you're opening a new chapter in your life, we want the best for you. And so the message, hopefully you carry with you, is put God first above all things in your life, and then to respect every person you encounter. Let us stand now and place our needs and petitions before God.
Jesus, teach us to love you more perfectly and our neighbors more deeply. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus, teach us to speak and follow the truth in a manner acceptable to you. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus, teach us to be pleasing to you in our hearts, in our minds, and in our works. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus, teach us how to joyfully suffer for you and how to unchain our fears. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus, reward us with those who have died, have everlasting life, everlasting glory with you. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we come before you this afternoon in praise and gratitude. Through this Eucharist, strengthen our faith, and if it is your will, we ask you to grant these prayers in the name of Jesus, who is Lord, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
his sacrifice, O Lord, humbly praying that, as you granted the blessed martyrs grace to die rather than sin, so you may bring us to minister at your altar in dedication to you alone. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God, our loving Father, we are glad to give you thanks and praise because you love us. Because you love us, you gave us this great and beautiful world. Because you love us, you sent your Son, Jesus, to bring us to you and to gather us around him as children of one family. For such great love, we thank you with the angels and saints as they praise you and we sing. When supper was ended, Jesus took the cup that was filled with wine. He thanked you, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember the There we shall be happy forever with the Virgin Mary, Mother of God and our Mother, Joseph, her spouse, the Apostles, Bernard, there all the friends of Jesus the Lord will sing a song of joy. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
And let us pray. We have received this divine sacrament, O Lord, as we celebrate the victory of your holy martyrs. May what helped them to endure torture, we pray, make us, in the face of our trials, steadfast in faith and in charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated. At this time, I'd like to invite Officer Kyle Miller forward.
Not used to using microphones, I'll try. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for coming out to the St. Bernard's Dairy graduation. For those of you who don't know, my name is Kyle Miller. Born and raised here in town. I see a lot of familiar faces, but in case you didn't know why, that's why I am. I've been with the Sheriff's Department here in Bennington County for 22 years. Wow. Yeah. 11 of that, I've been teaching the DARE program here at St. Bernard's, among other schools here in Bennington County. A little bit about the DARE program. A lot of you guys know what it is, maybe some don't. The DARE program was started back in the early 80s. 83 is actually the first year it was introduced. It was a program that was started out in Los Angeles, California. The police officers and teachers and people out there were seeing the same people committed the same crime over and over and over, kind of revolving door. They commit the crime, they go to jail, they get out, they commit the crime, they go to jail, they get out. They realized that by the time these people were 17, 18, 19, 20 years old, it was really too late to try to educate. So some proactive law enforcement officers, along with some really proactive teachers and educators, got the idea to put cops in schools talking to fifth and sixth graders about drugs and alcohol, the dangers of gangs, and stuff like that. It wasn't received real well, but through time and cooperation, you know, the DARE program is going, it's taught in every state in the United States. It's taught, I think it's about 75 different countries now worldwide. So yeah, it's grown huge. And with times changing, so has the DARE program changed. As we all know, when I was a fifth grader in Washington Elementary School back in the day, a lot of things have changed for these young fifth graders and the other students here at St. Bernard's compared to when I was in school. With that, the DARE program had to change. The current curriculum that we teach right now through the DARE program is called Keeping It Real, and it honestly just is that. We keep it real for these fifth grade students. The very first day of DARE class, I go into the classroom, I introduce myself, and the first thing I tell the kids is, if you guys ask me a question, I'm going to tell you the truth. You might not like the answer, but I'm going to tell you the truth. The one thing we've learned teaching kids kids nowadays, with the amount of electronics that are available to them, if you answer a question and say, well, you can't do that because I told you so, doesn't work anymore. You have to explain why. So now with the DARE program, we actually use fifth and sixth grade students from other schools that have come up with their own stories that we share in class. I share stories from my other classrooms, and then the students share stories with me, and we come up with the best answer. We get into internet safety, we get into bullying, social media stuff. Of course, we still talk about the drugs and alcohol and tobacco. That's still a huge thing. But the biggest thing that we teach the students now in DARE class, from the beginning to the end, is what we call decision-making skills. You know, we understand that kids always aren't going to make the right choice in life, and even as adults. So what we do is we teach the kids a way to make a safe decision. And if they do make a mistake, how you come back from that mistake so you don't make that mistake again. And as you'll hear from the essays that we have from our 3D outstanding readers this year, you'll hear that in their speeches. I do want to pass on a message from Sheriff Kuznia, who was at the DARE essay contest this year. He was extremely proud of this group of fifth graders at St. Bernard's Elementary. Coming from the Sheriff Kuznia, who has been involved with the DARE program for over 30 years, that's saying quite a bit. He was very, very impressed with his fifth grade class. He honestly said any one of the six kids in this class could have come up and read their DARE essays. He was just absolutely stunned by the quality of the product they had, which is also a credit to the school here at St. Bernard's. I guess kind of in closing, I mean, I'm going to be downstairs at the reception if anybody has any questions. Feel free to ask, but I really do honestly want to thank Mrs. Demars. She honestly has been a rock for me since day one of starting DARE. It was a big undertaking when I first took on the program, and she's always been a great help. I want to thank Father too. I was scared this year, like everybody else was, that we weren't going to have schools, we weren't going to have DARE, we weren't going to have this, we weren't going to have that. So to stand here at a DARE graduation this year, it really is a really good thing for me. It makes me happy. I was lucky enough that in my other schools this year, we were able to have a graduation ceremony in them too. So life's getting back to normal. So, thank you.
Hi, my name is Casey Fargo. My fifth grade teacher is Mrs. Mars, and my DARE officer is Deputy Kyle T. Miller. I live in a family of four, my older brother Kale, my mom Jill, and my dad Robbie. I have four pets, a dog named Max, two cats named Opal and Oliver, and a puppy named Velma. One of my favorite hobbies are playing video games. Today, I'll be talking about the dangers of drinking alcohol, resistance strategies, and reporting bullying. In DARE class, one of the first things we learned was the dangers of drinking alcohol. But alcohol is a drink that's illegal for anyone under the age of 21. It slows down the brain, body, and it might make you have the following: loss of coordination, poor judgment, memory loss, loss of self-control, or slow reflexes. Alcohol also weakens the heart muscle, reduces the amount of the blood pumped to and from the heart, and it can damage every organ of your body. Drinking too much alcohol at one time or drinking too much alcohol in general can slow down the body and lead to coma or death. If people want me to drink alcohol in the future, I'll tell them why alcohol is harmful and walk away. Please do the same. Next, I'll teach you about resistance strategies. Resistance is the refusal to take others' impact. So resistance strategies help you avoid dangerous situations such as drinking alcohol or smoking. There are five resistance strategies. The first one is avoiding the situation. With this resistance strategy, it helps you to stay away from certain areas where you know people do bad things, such as smoking. So I'd say you know certain areas around deeper falls where people smoke. That's where you avoid the situation. Another resistance strategy is strength in numbers. This means that you'd hang walk away. Another assistant strategy is saying no while giving a reason or an excuse. This means that if a drug user is offering you something like a cigarette or beer, just say no and give a reason or an excuse, like cigarettes damage your body or I'll get kicked out of my house if I drink beer. The last resistance strategy is changing the subject. This means that if someone is offering you a cigarette or beer, just say, how about soccer instead? If someone ever offers me a drug in the future, I'll just use one of the resistance strategies. Please do the same. The last topic I'll teach you about is reporting bullying. Bullying is an aggressive or unaccepted behavior done repeatedly to bother, harm, or control someone. So if you see someone being bullied, or if you're being bullied, you'll want to be or count on a bystander. A bystander is someone who sees bullying and has the chance to help by reporting. There are 5 steps to safely report bullying. These steps are called the 5 W's of reporting bullying. They are who, what, when, where, and why. Who stands for the person or group that's bullying? What stands for what the person or group is doing that's bullying? When stands for the time the bullying is happening. Where stands for the place the bullying is happening. Finally, why stands for the reason they are bullied. If I see someone being bullied, I'll use the 5 W's and report to a trusted adult. Please do the same. In conclusion, I loved DARE and it was one of my favorite classes in 5th grade. I enjoyed everything about DARE. I think everything I learned in DARE will help me tons in the future, no matter where I am. I, Casey Farwell, will take all the information that I learned about drugs, alcohol, and tobacco in DARE and use it for the future. Thank you for your time.
Hi, my name is Josiah German and I'm in 5th grade. My teacher is Ms. Samars and my DARE officer is Deputy Kyle T. Miller. I like to play with my Pastor C. Car, the World of Warships, and I have 5 brothers and 2 sisters. I'm going to talk about risky situations, safe and responsible choices, and resistance strategies. First, I'm gonna talk about risk situations. Risk means taking a chance. Risky situations are taking a chance to do something new. For example, working outside, trying a new sport, talking with people you aren't used to. My mom wants me to try to play tennis, and it is a risky situation for me. I'm still figuring out if I want to take the risk and play tennis. Secondly, I'm going to talk about safe and responsible choices. Choices are a person's right or power to choose. Safe choices are choices that keep us protected from harm, like wearing a helmet or biking. Being responsible is when you are able to distinguish between right or wrong. For example, trying to choose between hitting, not hitting brothers or sisters. Thirdly, I'm going to talk about resistance strategies. Resistance means a refusal to accept others' influences. Strategies are plans of action designed to achieve a major goal. One resistance strategy is to stay away from people we don't know, people who are smoking, people who are using drugs. drugs, alcohol, and tobacco. I, Josiah Truman, pledge to stay drug, tobacco, and alcohol free.
Candidates for graduation, please stand. The following students have met the requirements of the DARE program and have successfully completed the standards and curriculum set by the state of Minnesota and St. Bernard School. Candidates, as I call you by name, please come forward to receive your DARE certificate and your St. Bernard School graduation diploma. Casey Will Farbo. Josiah Matthew German. Ty Ross Herman. Ian Kelly Ledeen.
Officer Glory and one another.
Thanks be to God.
I just want to congratulate the graduates, and I just want you to know we love you, and we care deeply about you, and you're always welcome here. So.
Please join us in singing our closing song, number 466, in the Gathering Hymnal. When school started, the fifth graders started the school year by ringing a school bell as they entered the building. And now, as they end their education here at St. Bernard's, they will each be ringing the bell as they process out.
Thank you. problem solvers.
Next.